I got a special introduction today. What we have is our pumpkin that we got yesterday at Evan's Orchard, didn't we?
Yeah.
And we're going to make it into a jack-o'-lantern. We have a few pumpkins and gourds here. These are just for decoration.
We're going to make it into a monster.
We're going to make it into a monster. Now, Big Daddy, Rick, is going to be doing the carving, but I think he is doing it on the advice of Carter. So Carter's picked out something that he wants carved, and Big Daddy's going to do it, right?
Yeah.
What do you think he's going to do?
He's going to cut some of this pumpkin off, and he's gonna put the face on. Then he has to carve it, and he's gonna carve the face of the alien. Then he'll put it in there, and we need a little glue to put on there to make it stay there, and that's all I remember.
Okay, all right. We don't know exactly what's going to come out here, but I think Big Daddy's going to determine it. So we're going to start with the carving right now.
As not always, but usual, the first step is to cut a hole in the lid so we can access the pumpkin and get the goop out. So I'll just start cutting away. I'm going to try to put the face over here, even though there's a blemish here already cut off. That's the side that presents the best for a face. So I'm going to make that the front. So I'm going to go away for a minute and cut this out. Our top is cut out, and I did incline the knife a bit so as to be sure to have a ledge for the top to rest on when it goes back in. I also made a little bit of an elongation on one side to form a sort of a key so that you can know which way to put it in. So if you cut a perfectly round circle, that looks nice, but then you're playing puzzles to try to get the top back in when you need to. So next step is, what do you think?
To grab those things.
Grab those things and pull them out, right?
Yeah.
And you're going to do that for me, right?
No, I don't want to.
Why not?
Because I don't feel like that.
What would I have? I'm working on these seeds. Betty has a good recipe from last year on toasting pumpkin seeds to eat them. They're very tasty. Bit of a mess, but that's okay. What are you going to help?
I'm going to help with telling if the face is great. Yeah, the face is great.
And the face is great.
Yeah.
You want to eat some of these pumpkin seeds? I've cleaned out the inside pretty well. There's a few strings in there, but I'm not going to worry about them. And you see our pumpkin seeds ready for the toasting process. Okay, the next thing is to start carving. And last year, we carved the traditional style of pumpkin where you cut holes all the way through to let the light shine out. There's a sort of a new style that some people are adopting, which is a little bit more sophisticated and lots more artistry, which I'm not sure I'm up to, but we'll see. And that's to carve away sort of in base relief. You don't go all the way through, or you can mix it up and do that too, but mainly you dig down into the flesh to have a thinner layer of wall, which allows for the light to shine through more than where it's completely thick. So that's what we're going to try to do. Carter picked a pattern, which we have right here. Found an image on the internet and put it into a Word document, played around with it.
No, that's not the sized one, that's it, the alien one.
Printed it out. Well, that the alien is a different one. This is the one I thought you wanted to do. No, who is this?
Our Vader, but it's cut.
Well, that's okay. It's supposed to be.
I want the alien instead.
That's,
I think we're doing Darth
size.
Vader.
Yeah, but I want...
We're going to try that one on the little pumpkin, okay?
No, I want that one on this one.
So I have a pattern that I borrowed from the internet and scaled in a Word document and printed out and cut out the rough shape of it. So I'm just going to, as a starting point, I'm going to pin it to my pumpkin. in a few places and go around the outside edge with the marker. And then probably have to make some starting and ending points like so for the internal areas. Every part that's dark gray here is going to be left as natural skin. The whiter parts I'm going to carve away and make them thinner so that they will transmit more light. So that's the plan anyway. We'll see how it works. I've traced around the outside edge of this template and I put push pins in. It's sort of the stopping and starting points of many of the interior features, which we're going to use as guidelines to draw them in. And I hope to enlist Betty's help because she's much more artistic than I am. The problem with carving something is that you have to be able to draw it before you can carve it. And I'm not much of an artist. So this is one step. We've got more to go. Better or worse, here's what I have. Now it's time to start whacking away at the pumpkin. Here's a progress report. I've gone around the outline of everything with this V-carving chisel, which is probably something that most of you would not have, but you could use a knife just to make shallow cuts and do it. And I also have gone along one side to pare away the outer rind or pumpkin skin or hide or whatever it's called to show you what it's going to be like. And I'm going to do the same thing on the inner areas, except where the darker parts should be. So I've got a lot more work to go. Well, after several hours of tedious labor, here's what we have.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Ta-da! What do you have to say, Carter?
This is Darth Vader, and in a few seconds when it's all done, we're gonna go in the basement and turn all the lights out and watch it go. Whoa!
That'll be great.
Yeah.
Do you think Big Daddy did a great job?
Yeah.
I think so too.
My favorite part when I put my finger across here.
Oh yeah.
And it feels good.
Oh, that feels good, huh? Uh-huh. Well, good job, Big Daddy.
Thank you.
From our family to yours,
Happy Halloween!